So we saw how the Mac used 30 pin SIMs like this to store its memory. And we'll look later at what sort of information the computer stores in these things. But for now, I just want to look at how this actually stores information. Now, as I'm sure all of you are aware, it stores it in terms of binary digits or bits. But actually, what we're really interested in is just storing a single bit, and we can put them together to form lots of memory. So to understand how the memory works, we need to look at some of the basic digital logic circuits we can build using logic gates. Now, over on Numberphile, Matt Parker introduced these using dominoes to create various things. We're going to look at them in terms of the electronic chips. So you can buy your basic logic circuits in integrated circuits like this. This one's four OR gates. So we actually put them together in an electronic circuit to build memory. Now this is a bit odd because normally these are just used to process or combine various inputs, but if we connect them in a specific way, we can actually get them to store information, at least until the power's turned off. So what we've got here are two very basic electronic circuits. We've got an AND gate here and an OR gate in this chip here. These chips come with four AND gates or four OR gates together. And if we remember from the Numberphile video, an AND gate is on when both of its inputs are on. If either input is off, then the output is off. So in this case, I wired it up to a simple LED so that we can see the output of one of the AND gates. And I've wired both of the inputs to the positive voltage rail because we use positive 5 volts to represent true or 1 in binary, and we use ground or 0 volts to represent false or 0 in binary. Now, that's generally what we use with what was called Ttl logic. These days you use different voltage levels and so on, but the principle is the same. You have one voltage which represents false or 0 and another voltage which is generally higher that represents 1 or true. So if I take, hang on, if I just move these over so you can see what I'm doing. So both of these are currently connected to logic 1 or 5 volts. If I disconnect one and connect it to logic 0, you can see that immediately that light goes off because the AND gate has now got one input at 0, one input at 1, 1 and 0 is 0 by the laws of Boolean algebra. So we can combine these in different ways. And if I put them back in 1, both 1, it's on. Put them both to 0, then they're both off. Over here, I've got an OR gate. And if you remember back from the Numberphile video, an OR gate is on when either of its inputs are on or both of them are on. So I'm going to rewire the circuit to do that. So often you'll get books like this which will give you details of different things. The quad input positive OR gates has the inputs on pins 1 and 2 and the output on pin 3. The AND gate, the 7402, has the inputs on pins 2 and 3 and the outputs on pin 1. So connect the output to pin 3. And we can now start to connect the inputs. Now, in both cases, whoops, I've just shorted the.
A bit hot.
Yeah, just shorted the power supply, which is why it's making noise. So we connect both of these to. Look, the cable's all melted. Pin 0. And if we now unplug that and plug it into there, have I just broken everything?
You fried the chip.
I hope this gets edited out. Yes, that's right. I've either fried everything on here.
Are you now turning it off and on again?
I am indeed turning it off and on again here, in the hope that I haven't just shorted everything out.
Can we pause that?
Yeah, I think we might need to pause it. Smoke's cleared and we've just had a slight problem with the power supply, but we're back and running now. There's a little hamster running around in a wheel to power everything at the moment. So we've rewired this so that the output of the OR gate is now connected to the LED, and these are both tied to logic 0 through these resistors here. If I now connect any of these to logic 1, the input comes on. So that's input 2, connects to logic 1. Input 1, the input comes on. And of course, because it's an OR gate, if I connect the second input at the same time, then they're both on. We also get other versions of these chips, and these are called NAND gates or NOR gates. And they work in exactly the same way. They take two inputs and they AND them together. But immediately following that, built into the chip, is what's called a NOT gate, which inverts the output. So it's the opposite of an AND gate. Its output is off when both of its inputs are on. So we're going to open this up. There we are. So I'm going to take the AND chip out. There we are. And pop this chip in. Can be a pain because you have to bend all the legs to fit in. There we go. So that's now in place. So I've got to rewire it now to use the NAND gate that I've popped in there. So I connect the output to pin 3 of this circuit, and the LED, of course, comes on because both inputs 1 and 2 are wired to 0. Normally, an AND gate would be off because both of its inputs are 0, but this is the opposite of that, so both of its inputs are 0, it's now on. So if we connect input 2 to 5 volts, it stays on because 0 and 1 is 0. The inverse of that is 1. But if we connect input 1 as well to 5 volts, then the LED goes off because 1 and 1 is 1. The opposite of that is 0, so the LED is now off. But as soon as we disconnect one of the pins, it comes back on. And one of the fascinating things about NAND gates is that you could build a whole computer just using the circuits on this chip. You need lots of them, you need more than 4. But what we're going to do today is use not a NAND gate to start with, but a NOR gate, which is an OR then knotted, to actually build some memory. So over here, here's one I prepared earlier. We have a quad input NOR gate, so this is 4 NOR gates. So what I'm going to do is wire 2 NOR gates into a circuit so that it'll actually store the information that we put in it. I'm going to use this one on the left here and this one over here. Let me just check the wiring diagram. We have pins 1 is the output of the NOR gate, 2 and 3 are the inputs, and on the other side, pin 13 is the output and pin 11 and 12. So I'm going to connect the output of this NOR gate on the right hand side to the input of the one on the left hand side.
Do you call them A and B or something?
Yeah, so we're connecting the output of NOR gate B to the input of NOR gate A. I'm now going to connect the output of NOR gate A back to the input of NOR gate B. It's a very tight fit. There we go. So we've got these two things crossed over, but the output of one is connected to the input of the other. And just to make sure the circuit works, I'm just going to put some resistors to tie the other input to 0 volts, to our logic 0. This means that I can make them logic 1 or logic 0 just by touching the leg of the resistor with a wire connected to 5 volts later in the demonstration. So the other thing I'm going to do is I've connected the output of NOR gate A to this wire here, and I'm just going to put a LED across that wire to ground, like so. And I'm going to do the same on the other side, so I'll connect that up like so, there. And we'll see that this LED has now come on. So I now get a fly wire, plug this in to 5 volts like that. And if I touch this one, this LED comes on and it stays on. If I touch that one, that LED goes off and this one comes on and stays on. This circuit is remembering its state. And we can do that by just driving a signal into the chip. And it'll stay like that until I turn the power off. We need to look at how this circuit works. So what I'm going to do is draw it out. But before we do that, it'll be useful to refresh our memory of how a NOR gate works. So that's our NOR gate, and it has 2 inputs, which we'll label as A and B. And it has an output, which we'll label as Q. So we can build up a truth table for this. So normally with an OR gate, 0 or 0 would be 0, but we're inverting it because it's an OR gate, so the output is 1. 0 or 1 is 1, but it's inverted, so the output is 0. 1 or 0 is 1, but it's inverted, so the output is 0. 1 or 1 is 1, inverted, so the output is 0. So that's the truth table for our NOR gate. Now let's have a look at the circuit that we used over there. So we had our first NOR gate, and we also had our second NOR gate, like that. And we've got the inputs to these, like so. And we took the output from here and connected it to the input of that one. And we took the output from here and connected it here. We've now got two inputs left that we're not using, and I'm going to label them as R, because that's what we used to reset it, and we've got S, which is what we used to set it, or to store a bit. We've also got two outputs, and I'm going to label the first one Q, and the other one, we're going to call this not Q, and the way we do that is we draw a line over the top to say that this is not Q. Now, the thing we have to remember about these circuits is that they don't switch the output instantaneously when the input switches. There is a slight, very short delay, and depending on what type of chip you get, but there's always a slight delay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw out our truth table for this. So we've got input R, and we've got input S, we've got output Q, and output Q, not Q. But these are also inputs to this, so I'm actually going to put in Q prime and not Q prime. To start with, this is at zero, this is at zero. We don't know what these values are, so we'll leave them blank. What's the next value of Q going to be? So it's going to be zero, ord with the current value of not Q, knotted. So that's going to be represented as Q, knotted. Not Q, knotted is, of course, Q, because the two knots cancel out. So the value of Q prime is whatever the old value of Q was, effectively. Same happens for not Q prime. That's S, which is zero, ord with the old value of Q, knotted. So we get not Q. So as long as the two inputs are zero, you get the same values propagating through the circuit. But what happens if we set S to be 1? We'll leave R at 0. So our new value of Q is going to be the old value of not Q, ord with 0. So it's going to be not Q again. So it's going to be Q. Our new value of not Q is going to be S, which is 1. Ord with whatever the value of Q was, knotted. Now, if you OR anything with 1, if you think about the truth table, the answer is always 1. So not Q is going to be 0, because it's not of 1. So we're going to get a 0 in there. So we can feed those back in again. We've still got 0 and 1 as the input here. We now know that the output of Q bar, or not Q, is 0. So what's the new value of Q going to be? Well, it's the output of not Q, which is 0, ord with 0, which is 0, knotted, which is 1. The output of Q prime is going to be 1. And the output of Q bar prime, well, that's still 1, ord with whatever the output of Q was before, so we call that Q, that's always going to be 1, knotted, so that's going to be 0. And if we run those values through again, so we've got 0, 1, 1, 0, then we get the same values out, 1, 0. But the interesting thing is, when this becomes 0, and that becomes 0 again, Q is still at 1, not Q is still at 0. If we run the circuit through here, the new value of Q is the old value of not Q, ord with 0, that's 0, knotted, that's 1. And not Q prime is S, which is 0, with the old value of Q, which was 1, so that's 1, knotted, that's 0. So it stays the same, and you get the same input coming through. So it actually continues. And we could do the same thing with the reset, and you'd find if you work it through that it resets it and all the values go to 0. So that very simple circuit will actually store the state if it's set and if it's reset. And you can actually build up a complete memory circuit because you can put some very simple digital logic in front of that to generate the right S or R signal based on the value of a bit and whether you want to store it or not.
And everybody was going to click on that one. Well, it turned out that the video behind that was a person talking about the fight.
Only that will fall over. That won't move. Here we go. Ready?
And eventually the viewers would find it.